Now let us learn about multiple motions. That means sometimes object may have more than one type of a motion. That means at the same time it will exhibit more than one type of a motion. Let us take one example. Now suppose car is there like this. Wheels are there. Now car is moving from one point to another point. When car is moving from one point to another point, at the same time two types of a motion will be exhibited by it. How? The wheels of the car will have a rotatory motion, whereas car totally will have which motion? Translatory motion. So that means how many types of motions are there in motion of a car from one point to another point? Two types of a motions will be there. So this is called multiple motion. Multiple means more than one type of a motion will be exhibited at the same time. Okay. Now motion of a car, maybe you observed. When a spin bowler delivers the ball has a spin motion, that means rotatory motion, while it moves towards the batsman. Now maybe you know that when spin bowler is bowling the ball, generally what happens is the ball will move from one point to another point. From here to here it moves. That means it will have translatory motion. Apart from the translatory motion, it will have its rotatory motion also. Spin motion also will be there. That means two types of a motion will be there for spin ball. And a person drawing water from a well. Here the pulley on which rope runs has a rotatory motion, while bucket coming up has a translatory motion. So now suppose for example, one pulley will be there, on the pulley rope will be there, and for rope one bucket will be hanged, and you will generally dig the water by using this bucket from the well. And when you are dragging this particular rope by using your hand here, what happens? This pulley will move like this, circular motion, that means rotatory motion, and at the same time bucket will come up, it will have a translatory motion.
Translatory motion.
So more than one type of a motion is there or not here?
So yes, there is more than one type of motion. There are two types of motion. One is rotatory and the other is translatory.
Very good. So it is called multiple motion. So multiple motion can be exhibited. Now see here, a spinning top has which motion?
Sir, rotatory.
Right. A spinning top. Your voice is trembling. Tell me, Yashika, again.
Sir, I said the answer is A.
Right, rotatory. Very good. Spinning top will have a rotatory motion. Next question. See here, distance and displacement. If you observe it, this particular part of your session will be finished. So let us finish it. Now, distance and displacement. Now, if 10 to 20 minutes extra also, you have to be there in the class today. So we'll finish this chapter. Okay? Right. Now, distance and displacement. What is distance and displacement? Do you have an idea related to distance and displacement? Pragya, Yashika, Neha, do you have an idea?
Distance is
distance.
How much space is like we have? So how much space?
Right. Okay. So let me say.
Sir, I think distance is how much space is there between two points.
Okay. Right. Now see here. Tell me again, what do you mean by state of motion, Yashika?
Something that moves, something that changes its position.
Neha, you have to be there today. Not for all the times. I am not asking about all the times, no, Neha. Just today we have to finish it. That's why I am asking you to stay for some time, extra time. Okay? So be with me today. Okay. All right. Now see here, what do you mean by state of motion? Now state of motion is nothing but if the position of an object is changing with respect to time, then object is said to be in a state of motion. Now let me say like this, Yashika. Suppose object is there at A at 8 a.m. Now, object A is there at this position at 8:30 a.m. Now, tell me, object is in a state of motion or object is in a state of rest? Yashika?
Sir? Yeah, it's in A when it's for in 8 a.m. Mm. It's near A. It's in the point A. The object is...
No, object A. This is object A only. This is also same object. But the position of object is there.
Changing. The right. Position of object is changing.
Right. Pragya, you tell me whether it is in a state of motion or rest.
So I'm saying it's...
Sir, if a clock moves its hand, I think it's in the state of motion.
Right, it is in a state of motion. Why? Because at 8 o'clock it is there here, at 8:30 it is there here. Position is changing or not?
Sir, it's changing.
Right. Now tell me, from 8 to 8:30 it is reached here. Whether it traveled like this, or whether it traveled like this, or whether it traveled like this. In which path it traveled?
Sir, none of these paths, I think.
Why?
Sir, because from moving to 8 to 8:30, the clock will just move its hands. Like,
I'm asking about an object. Suppose this is a car. At 8 o'clock, it is there here. 8:30, it is there here. Now, from this point to this point, how it can come? It may come in this first path. It may come in second path.
It can come in any way it wants.
It may come in any manner. But here, let us say this is one object. And the initial position of this object is A here. Final position of object B is there here. Now, suppose first time it traveled like this. And second time it traveled like this. This is the first path and this is the second path. Now tell me, in these two paths, which of the path is shortest? Second or first one?
Second path, sir.
Second. The second path.
Very good. Second path is shortest one. First path is?
So the first path is like the longer one.
Longer one. Okay. Now the object may reach from point A to B in a first path, or it may reach from point A to B in a second path also, isn't it? Then some difference is there between first path and second path or not?
Yes, sir, there is a difference.
Right. Now, this first path generally we mention with a distance, and second path generally we mention it with a displacement. Now, what is the difference between these two? So let us try to understand about it. The actual length covered by a moving body in between two points. Two points means what? Initial point and final point. So the actual length covered by a moving body in between initial and final points, irrespective of direction. So you must not take direction. Without taking direction into consideration, how much actual length was covered by a moving body in between initial point and final point will be known as distance. So the actual length covered by a moving body in between two points, irrespective of the direction in which the body is moving, is called distance. So here you must not think about direction. But now let us try to understand about displacement. The shortest distance covered by a moving body in between initial and final points in a particular direction. Direction will be there here. Without a direction, you can't specify the displacement. So for displacement, definitely what will be there? Direction will be there. So the shortest distance covered by a moving body in between two points in a particular direction will be called displacement. Now, generally tell me, now you said second path is shortest, no, Pragya?
Yes, sir.
Right. Suppose if I draw like this, can I say this is the shortest path?
Sir, it's still the shortest. It's still the shortest.
This third path, suppose if I draw like this, can I say it is shortest path?
Sir, the third path that you have drawn, it's not the shortest path.
Right. Now, shortest path definitely will be a straight line like this or not?
Sir, the shortest path will definitely be a straight line.
Yeah, definitely be a straight line. That means from A to B, direction will be there for a displacement or not? Along a straight line only, it will be there, no?
Mm-hmm.
If it is curved one, whether it will be called displacement at that time? See, for displacement, you have to take particular direction, or without considering direction, you have to say it is displacement. Understand carefully. Now here I will draw again. This is initial point and this is final point. And I have to reach from point C to D. To go in a shortest way, in a shortest time, how I have to go?
Sir, we just have to go in a straight line.
Straight line like this, isn't it? From C to D, straight I have to go like this.
In a rectilinear.
Right, like a rectilinear, straight line you have to go.
Yeah, you have to go straight.
Right. So I have to go straight like this to reach in a shortest time means this is the shortest path only, no?
Yes,
and
sir.
Shortest path is there in a particular direction or not?
Sir, it's going in a particular direction.
Right. So particular direction is there and it is a shortest one. So the shortest distance covered by a moving body in a particular direction only will be called displacement. Suppose if an object is moving like this, you can't say this has displacement, but you have to say it has what? Distance. So for distance, it will not be the shortest one. Remember, shortest one only will be called displacement. And other than that displacement, all will be called what? Distance only.
Distance.
So that's why only here they wrote the actual length covered by a moving body in between two points, irrespective of its direction, is called a distance, and the shortest distance covered by a moving body in a particular direction will be called displacement. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Right. So that means for a displacement, direction will be, for a distance, no direction will be. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now let us solve few problems related to it.
Okay, sir.
Now, a man has to go 50 meter due north, 40 meter due east, 20 meter due south to reach field from his house. What distance he should walk to reach the field? What is his displacement from from his house to field? Now, suppose let us say some field is there here. Now, do you know about north, south, east, west directions? Generally, if I take this as north, this side, south will be there, and this side, which will be there? This is north. Opposite to north, south will be there. And to the right side of the north, what will be there?
East.
East will be there. East will be there or west will be there? East only will be there. And this side will be west. So north, south, east, west. Now observe carefully. A man has to go to his field from his house. Let us say here his house is there. And first he moved in a north.
So I got disconnected for a while. Can you tell me what you were saying?
Yashika?
Yes, sir.
Right, we are discussing about one problem here. So we are taking directions north, south, east, west. Generally, so let me draw like this. This is east, west, north, south. Right. So let us take like this. East, west, north, south. This one. Now first, a man is moving from his particular house. First, he traveled in which direction? North direction. So let us say from his field, first he moved in a north direction like this. How much distance he moved? 50 meter. And towards east, east means up. Towards east, up, how much distance he moved? 40 meter. And again, north, east. Now he moved towards south. So south, how much distance he moved? 20 meters he moved. Okay. And now see here, this is 50 meter and this is 20 meter only. And now what we have to find out? We have to find out what distance he walked to reach the field. So from this is his house, let us say this is position A, and up to B he moved first, next up to C he moved, next he moved up to D. AB will tell us about north direction, 50 meter he traveled. From B to C, 40 meter he traveled, which tells us about east direction. Let me draw like this, east direction, and next south direction to the 20 meters like this. Totally how much he moved? 50 plus 40 plus 20, that is 110 meter he moved. So this is 110 meters. This is also right here. Distance traveled will be 110. Tell me again, what do you mean by distance, Yashika? Yashika?
Sir, distance is a path taken. It's a path which is not even.
Okay, so that means it is not in a straight line. That is your point, no?
Yeah.
Right. Now, actual path covered. It may travel in a circular way. It may travel in a zigzag manner, whatever it may be. So, how much total distance he traveled will be said with distance. Total path, actual path, whatever he traveled will be known as distance. So, that's why I see here. To find out the distance here, what we have to do is distance will be equal to first he moved from A to B, and later he moved from B to C, later he moved from C to D. So total you have to add to get the distance. So AB how much? 50 meter. BC how much? 40 meter. CD how much? 20 meter. So 50 plus 40 plus 20, that is 110 meter. But now our aim is to find out displacement. Tell me, what is displacement? Shortest path only, no?
So displacement is the shortest path.
From where to where?
From one point to another point.
One point to another point from means from initial to final or final to initial?
From initial to final.
Right. Which is initial point here? A. And what is the final point here?
D.
D is the final point. So, what will be the shortest path from A to D? You have to join like this or not?
Yes, sir.
And you have to find out this value or not, AD?
No, yes, sir. We have to find out this value.
So if you want to find out the AD path, what I am doing is, I am drawing a line, perpendicular line from D like this. It will intersect AB or not like this.
Yes, sir.
AB line here or not?
Mm-hmm.
Right. So from A to B, totally 50 meter is there. Now I am thinking this point, intercept point as X. Now tell me, CD will be equal to BX or not? This and this will be same or not?
Sir, they are the same.
It will look like a rectangle or not, this box. Let us take this as
possible. Sir, yes, it's like a rectangle. It is a rectangle.
Right. The second box look like a rectangle or not?
It does.
Right. So from B to X, how much will be if it is a rectangle?
Sir, from B to X, it will be 20.
Right, B to X, it will be 20 meter. Have you got Yashika? B to X will be 20, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Right. Now tell me, from X to A, how much will be there?
Sir, I can't see the X.
Here it is there. Here. Round, I am putting X here, this point, point intersection.
B to X, it's 20 meter.
Okay, B to X will be 20 meter, as it look like a rectangle. How much CD will be there? Same BX will be there. That's why I took 20 meters. Now tell me, what is the remaining portion from A to X? From A to B, total 50 meter. Already you know that. So already 20 here. How much will left with the AX?
It's going to be 30 meter.
Huh? How much?
30 meter.
Very good. It is a 30 meter. So ax will be 30 meter. And now tell me, xd will be how much xd from here to here?
It's going to be 40 meter.
Very good. It is a 40 meter. Why? Because it will look like a rectangle. Opposite sides will be equal. Now cd will be equal to bx. That's why I wrote 20. BC will be equal to XD. That's why I wrote 40. So here, 30 meter, 40 meter, and AD. Now observe carefully this particular triangle, which I'm drawing here again. A, D, X. It is there like this or not? A, D, X. And AX will be 30 meter. DX will be 40 meter. Now,
so how do we measure A and D? AD.
That only I am going to say now. Okay. Now, do you know about triangles? Do you know about triangles?
Yes, sir.
What type of triangle it is?
Sir, I think it's an isosceles triangle. No, sir. Scalene triangle.
Ethika, can you say what type of triangle it is?
There are types of triangles.
You don't know about types of a triangle?
No, sir.
Neha, do you know types of a triangle? Neha, you have not understood about displacement. Okay, displacement always will be shortest point only, and that only I am explaining with this particular problem. And try to understand, and after that again I will tell you. Okay, Neha, I have not seen your messages, so okay, after this particular problem I'll explain. Okay, now this is generally called a right angular triangle. If any one of the angle is 90 degrees, then it will be called which triangle? Right angular triangle. Okay, Yashika.
Yes, I'm listening.
Right, it is called right angular triangle. And in a right angular triangle, remember always this AD will be called a hypotenuse, and AD whole square will be given by one formula, and that formula will be called Pythagoras theorem. And according to that Pythagoras theorem, we can write like this: AD square is equal to AX square plus XD whole square. Generally, AX will be called base, XD will be called height, AD will be called hypotenuse. Hypotenuse whole square is equal to base square plus height square. That formula will be there. So, AD square is equal to AX. AX, how much it is? 30 meters. So, 30 whole square plus XD whole square. How much it will be? 40 whole square. Now, AD square is equal to 30 square means 900, 40 square means 1600. So here I'll write AD square is equal to totally how much? 1600 plus 900, 2500.
I didn't get it.
Okay. Now this would look like a right angular triangle or not? If any one of the angle is 90 degrees, it will be called right angular triangle. Is it okay?
Yeah, sir, it looks like one.
Okay. Now, in a right angular triangle, we can apply one theorem which is called Pythagoras theorem. Which theorem? Maybe you are not having an idea about this theorem, and in your mathematics, it will be there. One scientist called Pythagoras.